الله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The Honorable Commissioner of Finance, Special Advisors, Special Assistants, Director of Protocol, our big host, our big friend, the NYC coordinator of the Gas State, the Oliver Twist of the Gas. NYC family, Assalamu alaikum. Indeed, I'm really very pleased to receive you today and to listen to a well-structured presentation done by the coordinator that appealed to the science, that appealed to logic as well. And I believe I agree with him in almost all what he said. The agricultural sector is our only survival in the country today. With the dwindling oil prices, and was possible or probable decline in oil prices near future because of the economic indices and implications, I believe we have to look inward as a nation and as Jigawa State to be able to keep our economy going. We all know that in almost every year recently you find discoveries of oil in different countries. We also know that the West and the East are busy in their research laboratories developing hybrid cars, battery cars, solar technology, wind technology to power, and so on, to reduce the consumption of oil. So we also know if there is increased supply and decrease in demand, price is bound to collapse. And that is what we are facing today. And this will continue. So we believe there is a real serious need to focus on agriculture for us to rescue the country from total collapse. I believe we will do much more than what you asked in agriculture. In addition to providing new land, we want to carry you along on all our new initiatives. And I believe if it is possible to even have one NYC farm in every local government, we will definitely we will involve you in all our research and development through our research institute. And I will be very glad to tap from your 20, 21 years experience. I'm sure education is center to every development. And as much as we want to do agriculture or create the agriculture body chain, you need human power. And if you don't train your manpower, then you will have to hire somewhere, which makes development meaningless when you have your people unemployed or don't have the capacity to be employed. So education is centered to all our policies. And I believe what you outlined will go a long way in helping us pass the basic knowledge to the corpus so that they will do better. We appreciate this initiative, and we are 100% willing to partner with you to make sure it is done successfully. Skill acquisition is a little bit a problem area. What we noticed over the years, there have been a lot of skill acquisition programs. But because we fail to assess the demand, they end up being a kind of jungle, putting together people, teach them a trade and profession that has no actual demand, churn them out, gives them capital and they cannot sell, and then they go back to square one in a month or two. So what I want you to include in your program also for the state is to see how we'll have targeted intervention on skill development that is demand driving. If we are training people to learn how to produce soap, we have to be sure there is market and demand for the soap that they will produce. And they will be able to compete with the existing market in price and quality as well. If you teach them on how to produce soap, gives them capital, and they produce soap without analyzing the market or showing them entry into the market, then after 1 or 2 months they get tired of it, eat of the capital you give, and we go back to square one. So I would want the NYC to include or to devise a means for us to do targeted intervention in skill acquisition, so that when we train people in professional business, we link them up with the market and we appraise the sustainability of the project that we do. That is why we started with the Gold Training Scheme that has been successful in many countries. It is a widow program that we give 3 girls to a widow for backyard farming, and that has proven to be very successful because the girls basically require not much. They can feed around the village, and the children or the widow normally manage to give them water and then they can feed around. So the maintenance and the upkeep of the girls is very minimal. It's something that is manageable by the widows. And at the end, the result is really very good. We have tested this, the program, and there has been between 50 to 70% success story on that. So we have started with that, and if there are similar interventions that are really demand driving and we look at the sustainability carefully well, we will want to partner with you and see how to develop this skill. And I believe even in training the NYC, you have to look holistically, where they come from, where they are going back to, what kind of business profession that you teach them, that there is an existing demand. On health, I believe we have been the doctors a little bit more than the other corpus, but I will ask for a survey across the country to find out what is our situation, and see if there is possibility to do to increase it. It's not really very easy, but as you are aware, we are doing a lot in health. We are sending 60 giga intelligence to China to read medicine. We are sending also 150 nurses and midwives to Thailand or so to read nursing and midwifery, so that at the end we will have at least one health center or a small clinic in every ward of the state. And then the hard-to-reach areas will now benefit from what we are doing now. And in our selection process, we pick four from every local government. And I really believe it will be a successful vision, was the vision that when they return, they will at least stay for 3 to 4 years in their own locality to support and help the people. I believe if we can work out something with the NYSC on this direction, it will be something that will be very, very, very happy with. And as you are aware, we have acute shortages of medical personnel, and that we intend to bridge. So You are welcome to discuss with the Honorable Commissioner of Health for all your needs on the best way to approach the situation, both on the members you have now and how we can attract more to come to Jigawa State, because we are in dear need of medical personnel. On the transit camp, so we will look at it, and I believe it is already in this year's budget. I think we will study if it is indeed, but I think something has been mentioned about it, and I think it is on this year's budget, and we will look at it and see how to continue the project and finalize. We will look also at the issue of the vehicle and the secretariat. Inshallah, we will do something. But I got a report yesterday that the LYC is looking for ambulance, not vehicle for the secretariat. But anyway, now that I hear from you, and then I believe it is the vehicle for the secretariat. I thank you once again for coming. I really appreciate it. And I'm happy with what I hear and with what I see. And I believe we indeed have partners in the state. Thank you very much.